Greetings, consciousness. Welcome back. And so now that you understand a bit about the tree of life, I figured it would be injustice for me not to share this knowledge with you. And this knowledge is about the mystical man of ancient Kemet. The mystical man of ancient Kemet. You see, what has happened in the earth is the modern man has no understanding of the original man of ancient Kemet. And even though we have this so-called technological advancement, we call it today, and many religions in this planet, very few people can even fathom the ideas and ideals of the original man of ancient Kemet, who called themselves gods on earth. But I think now that you guys are enlightened, you can understand this concept of gods on earth. Because you see, originally, people looked at the seven temples or the seven gods of ancient Kemet and called them idol worshippers, especially those in this modern day religions, with no knowledge of self and no understanding. But your minds are more illuminated than those without. You see, the things the ancient Kemites were doing, were not done without a purpose or without understanding. And so all these temples, these seven temples they created for each Neter or each god meant something. And when they talked about Egypt, which is in the center of the earth, which caused the gods to sojourn on the earth, they did not mean literally gods coming down to earth. But now that you understand their knowledge of creation, which was Kemetic tree of life, through the flower of life, you now have the Kabbalistic tree of life. But obviously, you know, even Moses, they said, studied in Kemet. We will not get into this type of stuff because you already know my thoughts on these things or on such matters. So let's discuss this. In your Bible, you were told that the Israelites went into captivity in Egypt. And those who entered Egypt were 70 men that entered Egypt. For your own illumination, in mysticism, I told you zeros don't count. Therefore, when you remove the zero on the 70, you end up with number 7. This is a representation of the seven gods descending into a physical body. Thus, you have 7 bodies. And so these 7 gods of creation, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. This is the incarnation of the spiritual bodies. That is why in the Hermetica, they said Atum asked all the seven gods to bring their attributes to that which he wanted to create. And so these are the incarnation of these seven gods. They said 70 men went into Egypt. We are not talking about literalism. Nobody went into bondage in Egypt. This is metaphysical, esoteric. And so the Holy Land, which was once called Kemet, modern day Egypt. This is why the Kemites wrote this place that was so beautiful, that enticed the gods to sojourn on this planet. Because in creation, the earth was so beautiful that Atum wanted to place a man, a spiritual being in a physical body on earth. But this entity needed various bodies to incarnate in a physical body, to have a relationship with the earth. And so 70 people did not enter Egypt, but rather the seven bodies which entered the physical body through the soul. Now you have to ask yourself, how many years were they in captivity according to the biblical story, which people read literally? It was 430 years. You remove the zero again. 4 + 3 = 7. So you're talking about the incarnation of the seven gods. Thus, you have the seven chakras, the seven wheels in a human soul. And so all this is about creation, how the spiritual entities entered a physical realm. And so the wandering of the desert for 40 years is all about the four elements, which has become the cross. The cross has four points on it. So you have earth, water, air, and fire. And so these ancient mystics of Kemet, who called themselves gods because they knew all these entities dwell within man, because man is a microcosm of the macrocosm, as above, so below. It is only because man has now become materialistic that we have lost our mystical nature. And so the modern man looked upon Egypt or Kemet and called them idol worshippers, because they had animal heads on these seven netters, which they did not understand. They represented something. And so it takes only those who study, who gain wisdom, which again is from the god Mercury. Mercury is the one that imparts knowledge, wisdom on men. So men today have no understanding of their spiritual nature or who they really are. And so we only live to satisfy ourselves in the external world, But the world within we know nothing of, because we have lost our spiritual or our mystical nature. Therefore, when you look at the Kabbalistic tree of life, Abraham, the father of many nations, or the father of many people, or the father of many, Abraham only represents Jupiter. Jacob represents the sun in the center of the Kabbalistic tree of life, the Messiah, the Savior. And Isaac is Mars, the fire. That is why Abraham was to sacrifice Isaac on a mountain. How do you sacrifice? You set up an altar and you burn the sacrifice. These are the three O's. That is why you hear every time Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac. If you look at the tree of life in the middle section where the sun is, Ra, you see the three are always together in the middle section. Hagar and Isaac, Ishmael, are a representation of the earth at the bottom. That's why Hagar was an Egyptian. We are not talking about literal Egypt, but we're talking about the earth. How the spirit came into bondage, into matter on a planet called Earth. Or physically, we're talking about the body. Now, you know, Jacob, obviously, in the center, the sun, whose name was changed into Israel. And I've told you before, Israel represents your soul. And so the sun, Jacob, or Ra, or Jesus, the Savior. When you look at the tree of life, in the middle path, Earth, you have the moon, second baptism. You see, all these things are esoteric. This middle path, you have the sun. When the Christ comes, or the Savior, Messiah comes, he will baptize you with fire. You have Mars. Going up on a middle path, you end up with Da'at. Da'at is knowledge. This is Sarah, the mother. In Kemet, Anubis, Sirius. And so going up on the middle path, Sirius is the Milky Way. And on the left, you have Saturn, Jehovah. On the right of Saturn, you have the realm of the fixed stars, the zodiac. That is why Tawiti said, you are stars on the earth. And above that, obviously, you have the spiritual plane. Before physical incarnations. And so the ancient Kemites, with this knowledge, managed to bring knowledge from Da'at, the spiritual plane, to create monuments on this planet that a modern man still don't have the machinery to build. All the ancient people on the earth lived in harmony with the universe. And so I'll show you another tree of life. It's not very clear. So you can see these images on the tree of life. I thought it was very important to share this with you. Because the Bible is not about some God who sends his son to die on a cross or coming to destroy the earth. But we need to understand these are all esoteric knowledge. We need to gain enlightenment so we can find ourselves. Otherwise, people are in religion and are in fear, and fear destroys a body. All these religions in the earth is all about alchemy. In Judaism, obviously, you can see the Sephiroth, the tree of life. And so when we talk about gods and goddesses, goddesses meaning you have the moon, you have Venus. In fact, when they talk about Elohim, you're talking about gods and goddesses, male and female, androgynous. That's our soul. As you can see, the sun in the center comes down through the moon before the earth. And so we are also male and female. In Kemet, you had Isis, Ra, and El. The El is the male principle. Aset or Isis is the female principle. The Holy Trinity. And so this is for your own enlightenment. And so with this said, I hope you understand. Because people have literalized all these characters in the Bible. But even Paul in Galatians 4:22 told you, this story is an allegory. Because those who wrote the Bible understood all these things. But because the Bible is written in this story form, it is hiding a deeper truth. But only those who understand it can appreciate what the book is saying. Because the Bible is really a Kabbalistic and a Kemetic writing, which has been literally modernized in the New Testament. That's all you're dealing with. And so with this said, I hope you can gain some understanding in this podcast. Peace.